In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can add topography to an Autodesk Revit project. Before I add the topography, I need to be familiar with my levels and exactly where I want to put my ground at. So I'm going to switch to my south elevation here. And I can see that the garage door is on the foundation level. So that is at negative 10 and 3/4 inches. And I want my land to line up there with the bottom of the garage. However, as we go away from the garage, I probably want that to slope down a little bit below the siding. And then, of course, as we continue down from there, we want to make sure that the land continues to slope away from the house. So at least initially, I'm going to use this negative 10 and 3/4 inch value. I'm going to switch to my site plan. And in order to place those points around the house, I need to be able to see through the roof. I can either make it transparent or I can just simply hide it. I'm going to go ahead and hide it for now. I'll select my glasses here and hide the element. Now I can switch to the Massing and Site tab and start the Toposurface tool. You can see in the options bar, I can enter in an elevation. So we know that that needs to be negative 10 and 3/4 inches based on what we just saw. Then I can come in here and click at the garage door opening. So this lower one is the footing. I'm going to come up to the wall and snap to the points of the garage door opening. Then from there, I'm going to lower this down a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and say negative 1 foot. And then I'm going to go ahead and select each corner of the building. Then, as I said earlier, I want the land to slope away from the house for drainage purposes, so I'm going to lower this even more. I'm going to go with a larger value just so that you can see this more easily on screen, and then I can go ahead and continue to place points further away from the house. And if I wanted to, I can even go with another lower level from there and place additional points. If at any point in time I want to adjust those points, I can just simply select them and change their elevation over here in the properties. I'm going to go ahead and finish the surface. When you're creating the surface, if you get a message about not being able to view the surface, you're just going to want to adjust your view range. If I go to my properties and select Edit View Range here, by default, the view depth is normally going to the next level down, which is probably going to be the foundation by default. You can set this to a lower level or just simply unlimited so that you'll be able to see the land as it slopes down away from this particular plane. I'll switch to 3D and we can see the land that was created there, and we can see how it slopes away from the house and how it lines up with the garage door before it slopes down and away. Next, I want to subdivide this topography. That way I can add in a driveway, maybe some sidewalks, maybe a flower bed. To do that, I'm going to return to my site plan here, and here on my Massing and Site tab, select subregion. Then I'm just simply going to draw in a closed shape. So for the garage here, I'm going to snap to the endpoints, or maybe I'll go out a little further, maybe even to the edge of the garage here. And I'll just simply draw out. I don't have to line up with the edge of the topography as long as I go past it. Then I'll come back here and create the rest of the shape here. Again, I'm just going to go past it. Not too worried about lining it up. And I'll use my TR for trim to put those together. Now I can go ahead and finish. And if I switch back to 3D, I see that I have a separate region. It's important to use the subregion tool and not just create another region, because this relates it to the original topography. If I change any of the points on the topography, then the driveway will update. Let's see that again. I'm going to add in a sidewalk, and I could add the sidewalk and make it the same object as the driveway, but I'll go ahead and do a different one. I'll do a subregion, And then once more, I'm just going to simply draw in what that subregion is going to look like. And finish. And there you can see my next little subregion there. I'll do one more to create a flower bed around the side of the house here. So once more, subregion, and again, I can do some rounding if I want to, but I'm going to keep it pretty simple for this example. There we go. So now you can see that I have four surfaces in total. So I don't want to put this on dirt. I'm going to go ahead and select the material here for the overall topo surface. Then in the properties, change from by category for the material to some sort of grass material. I'm going to go ahead and search for grass here in my project. And I'll select the grass that I have here. Obviously, I have some more that I can copy in if I want. But I'll just accept the default, and I'm going to tell it to use the render appearance here to make sure that the shaded view is green. And there I can see my different material. Notice the subregions stayed as the dirt, so I'm also going to want to edit those as well. So I'll select one of those, and maybe I'll look for some sort of concrete here for this one. And then I can do the same thing for the sidewalk as well. And then of course I can go ahead and leave this as dirt. You can see that my concrete is showing up black, and that's just from the material properties. If I get back into the materials, I can choose the use render appearance option, and then it will pick a color that's closer to the concrete color for me. Either way, it will render properly. I can add in some trees by using the site component tool and then selecting some different types of shrubs or trees. Maybe I want to put a couple of little shrubs here in my flower bed, maybe a couple of larger trees around the house here. And then if I go ahead and render it, I'll get a better view of what this is going to look like. So I'll just switch to a rendered view here. And there's my rendered view. You can see the material for the grass and the concrete, and you can see the rendered versions of the trees and shrubs as well. There is one more thing I want to take a look at, and to do so, I'm going to switch to a plan view. And I'm going to create a section view across the house here. And I'll jump to that section view. So you can see the problem that I have here is that I actually have a basement full of dirt. So we need to get that dirt out of the basement. And in order to do that, we're going to use a building pad. Since I know I want the building pad down here on the basement level, I'm going to switch to the basement level. Then I am going to go to the Massing and Site tab and select Building Pad. Then using my Pick Walls tool, I will pick the exterior walls of the house. It is not excavated underneath the garage, so I'm only going to draw under the rest of the house here. Then I can go ahead and click Finish. I'll switch back to the section view, and you can see that there's no longer dirt in my basement. I do have a pad object in here. If I edit type after selecting it, I can edit the structure and I can give it a different thickness. By default, this is actually pretty thick and shows up on screen, so I've adjusted my value to a half inch. I can even lower it if I want. So perhaps I will set a negative offset value to actually get it below the floor, since again, we want it to block everything below the floor, and that way I don't have to worry about it showing up in other views. I'll create one more section view, this time cutting through the garage. And you can see how we still have dirt underneath the garage, but not in the basement. To finish up then, I'm just going to return to my site plan and reset my temporary hides so that I have my roof back. That concludes this look at adding topography in Autodesk Revit.